Okay, we're chasing threads here, clearing out the threads where there's dirt, corrosion, maybe even a little paint. So we have got a nice long tap here. That show you that. Here's my tap handle. This is the 5/16 by 18 thread per inch tap that we're going to use as actually a thread chaser in this case. We're already done the one side here. As you can see, it's nice and shiny. I've put lubricant on the tap here. And we'll carefully thread this in here and get it started, because this is an alloy. I think it's aluminum. I'm assuming this inner piece is cast aluminum. At any rate, it's a softer metal, so we need to be careful. We don't want to damage anything. And it's cutting right on through here and threading, clearing out the threads, and it's getting easier to turn. There we go. That's probably good. I'll back her out. About got it. There we go. And let's see. All right, I can see some of the gunk that's on there. It's a combination of crud and dirt and a little bit of metal. I don't see any red paint on that one. Okay. Just very little bit, I think. I got just a little bit of air left here. Let's see if we can blow that dry, blow the chips out. I'm getting ready to install the oil mist lubricator assembly here into this housing. This is the diffuser housing. I've already lubed all these AN fittings here. These are oil lines that connect to the lubricator assembly. So we're going to start this here. I don't know if it matters. Maybe easier to start it on the oil mist lubricator. But anyway, let's see. Here's the assembly. Make sure these are all hand started, no cross threading. See how far off we are. Oh yeah, this is looking pretty good. I guess I shouldn't be questioning it, but is this a jet engine after all? I'm assuming the engineering is fairly close tolerances, so if it came out, it should line back up. Okay, well, so far so good. Get here where we gotta slide it up here. What we're going to do is adjust these tubings. The position of these tubes where they go through their seals out of the case. So we install these fasteners. I've already installed the proper anti-seize compound on here. So maybe we can start one of these bolts. Screws, I guess actually they're really screws. Hold your tongue just right. Really, I think they'll. I mean, they already got started here. Yep. It started. Sorry if I moved that. I think it's. Alright, there's one more screw and an AN washer. AN being Army, Navy, I don't know what they call them. They're really. Kind of hard to see it. Oh, sorry. I got the really thin flat washer. Fits right under the head of this screw. And these screws have to be lock wired once everything's torqued and everything's good. They have holes drilled through the heads in order to lock wire them and secure them. With the security each other in this case. So they don't unscrew. Okay, they're pretty well threaded down in there enough to still allow this to move a little if we need to. Alright, keep tightening that up. Let's get these down to where they're almost just finger snug, but still can give a little bit here. Alright, now this one's a little trickier because it's going to take getting these heater leads through. These should just push through here because it's really not going through a T or any something. It's not going through anything extremely sharp. You just see the two bends of the pipe here. So we'll shove those through. Believe it or not, those go through. The oil is, this is the oil mist outlet pipe, and that means that it's got to, the oil mist goes through with these leads, believe it or not. There we go. Pull the slack out of them. Okay. I'm gonna get this here where it looks like it's halfway lined. Sometimes these get bent in handling, so you gotta be sure that they're, oh yeah, look at that. Now it's not trying to escape and pull and go crooked. Now if we can just get this fitting started and draw this up, we'll be good. There we go. Okay, now everything's connected, finger tight. And, well, it looks pretty good. It has a torque specification for those two screws. So here we go, let's see. Well, it's called a bolt, comma, oil mist lubricator. The manual is specifying 100 pound inches minimum and 120 pound inches maximum. Once again, let's get reading glasses so we can see little numbers. All right, take our trusty snap-on torque wrench and we will set it to, we will shoot for 110 pound inches. Notice I'm, of course, always dial up to the setting. It's been stored with it set to zero or all the way as loose as it will go. Right there is 100 pounds inch, so we'll go one more revolution and that gives you 110 pound inches. Locked. Put our socket on here to this. Okay, now you can see I've used a an extension, which normally we don't want to do, but being where this is and it's pound inches, not pound feet, so I believe a little bit of twist in this short extension will be negligible for affecting a torque reading. So we'll just be sure we, guess I could have tightened that down by hand a little bit more, but that's okay. It does have a ratchet. Here we go. Snugging up. Snugging. Okay, now we're gonna go to our 110, see what happens here. Let's go to this one. Back on this one. Okay, not going anywhere. Seems to be tight. Try this one. Okay, fairly convinced it. Mr. Snap-on says 110 pound inches. We'll stop it there. Unlock and we'll dial her back down to the bottom for storage to the next setting we need. And then now we okay, and now we will snug up our AN fittings here on our line, our oil pipes, oil lines. Put Snap-on back in this nice little case so as not to damage it. Yeah. may have to use a backing wrench here. These don't need to be really, really, really super tight in order to make a nice seal, because that's the beauty of the AM style fitting. They will seal really well without a lot of extra force and effort, and they're quick and efficient. Let's see, that big one, that's 11/16, I'm going to guess. Been doing this long enough, starting to learn. Guessing its sizes anyway, how's that? We don't want to over tighten. All these are aluminum fittings. They're soft and you can damage them if you over tighten them. So it's better to hold the wrench in the middle, not way out here, because that this easily puts a lot of force. If you hold it closer to where you're that you're using, you're less likely to damage. Snug this up a little bit more. We don't want any leaks. If this one leaked, it would be oil dripping into this housing. This is the bottom of the reservoir, as you say, holds oil, so that would drip. The others are pressure from the compressor bleed, from the compressor or discharge area, and the other one's the outlet of the oil mist towards the bearing, so we don't want any of those to leak or not have pressure. So we don't want any of those to leak or lose any pressure. Alright, I think we're good here. And there is an oil mist lubricator installed, except I guess it's not, because we have not yet safety wired those two bolts. That may be next. What do you think? Finally, we got a sub-assembly assembled, so now we have our diffuser here pretty much together, ready to install when we get some other sub-assemblies together, and it'll maybe one day start looking like an engine. Okay, here we go. I want to show you that. Let me get the camera set here. Okay. This is what you've been seeing this whole time. It's leaning a little bit, but that's because that's just where it seemed to roll. On the engine, this index, this hole right here is going to be at the very top, dead center, 12 o'clock high position, and this would be 6. Alright, so she's ready to go. We're going to bag this up and it will be stored away here for hopefully not real long. But for the time being, to keep it clean until we're ready to actually install it in the cowling and start assembling this engine. But it takes time. We've got to get all the sub-assemblies together, and that's what we're going to work on. The next, I think the next major sub-assembly will be the exhaust nozzle housing. So that will be interesting. It has its own share of intricate parts, and pretty cool how it works. So. Okay, well, this is going to conclude the diffuser sub-assembly, diffuser housing preparation and reassembly. So, we got the diffuser all bagged up here now until we're ready to actually install. Let's see if we can show that here. See, got a bag here on it. Up. There we go. That keeps it clean. Dust. Keeps it cleaned up, ready to go, until we're ready to do the final assembly of the engine. Alright, well, we have here in the background is some of the future projects for sub-assemblies. Here we have the cowling, which has been kind of polished up. Has a nice luster to it. That will, of course, holds the whole thing together. And then here, I believe the next big project here, sub-assembly, will be this is called the exhaust nozzle housing. And that has a As I think I mentioned earlier in this video, it has its own share of pieces and parts. I got it painted. Let me turn around here and look. I got it painted with some barbecue grill paint, high temp paint. It's a flat black. It's really going to be for looks more than anything. Obviously, the temperatures inside it would be way hotter than that. So that's a moot point painting it a light coat here. If nothing else, just to see what it looked like. Good for the photo ops. There won't be much left of that once it gets hot. It'll just be down to the stainless steel metal that it is. Outside here, though, this has an air passage for cooling air between here and the actual jet pipe. So we have, or nozzle, I guess this actually is. The jet pipe attaches here, and that goes out here a little bit. So at this point, so this cooling air goes between here and the outer, very outer shell. So this paint has some chance of surviving. And here's the intake manifold for a J44. Wait a minute. Nope, that's silly. This is a small block Chevy intake manifold. A performer RPM. I'll probably be putting that on the old hillbilly rat rod. May do that here when it gets warmer. Have some fun. The old carburetor on it's pretty well worn out, so be time for a new one. But I'm going to do a different intake. Different format, so that'll be another day. From a small garage somewhere in Indiana, thanks for your interest. Thanks for watching.